Hello everyone, welcome to Foodie Mom. I hope all of you are doing good. So today I am making palak chicken, or you can say palak gosht, or you can say spinach chicken masala, or whatever you feel like. So for this, I am taking all these ingredients. Here are 3 medium sized onions sliced. This is 700 grams of chicken. This is 350 grams of spinach, washed and loosely chopped. This is the refined oil that I'll be using, and I've taken 5 tablespoons of ginger garlic paste, and these are the dry spices that I'll be using. I have slit 4 green chilies, 1/2 teaspoon of turmeric, 1 teaspoon of degi mirch, salt to taste. This is 1 tablespoon of garam masala, 1 tablespoon of cumin seeds, and 4 tablespoons of coriander powder. And I've taken a pan over here in which I'll be putting about 4 service spoon of oil, in which we'll be frying our onions till they turn goldenish brown. Yeah, so let's start with the recipe, and I hope you like my recipe. If you do, give me a thumbs up. Do not forget to subscribe my channel, that is Foodie Mom. So I'm adding in onions. So we'll be frying onions on high flame. Over here I have taken another pan in which I'll be cooking spinach that I have washed and chopped till it releases all its water, and we'll be putting in 2 pinch of salt, but before we have to just blanch it. So spinach is really good for your hair, eyes, skin, because it is rich in vitamin A, and also you do not have to cook spinach too much. It should not be overcooked, otherwise all its nutrient will just vanish away. So let's cook the spinach, as well as over here the onions are getting golden brown. Now as you can see, spinach has started to leave its water, so we'll cook it till all its water gets evaporated. And now we'll put 2 pinches of salt to just fasten up the whole process. Our spinach is cooked now, and since it was baby spinach, it has left lots of water. So what we'll do, I have thought about a different, altogether a different idea to it, that we'll use this water to cook our chicken too. So we'll not drain the spinach, or we'll not wait to get the water evaporated. We'll use this water to cook our chicken. So over here, our onions have turned golden brown. So now I'll put in the chicken and we'll just saute it for about 5 minutes. So I'm doing this on high flame so that all the water of chicken gets evaporated. Now I'm adding 5 tablespoons of ginger garlic paste. And we'll stir all of them together. Now adding this platter to the pan. You can also add chicken masala, of CAS or MDH or any kind of brand you want. This is totally optional. And if you want to use a chicken masala, use it 1 teaspoon. That will be good. So now let's stir all these together and cook for 5 minutes. There are other chicken recipes also that I have prepared, like drumstick masala, that is chicken tangri masala, chicken bhuna masala I have made. So all the links will be given in the description box. If you like to have a look, please go there and give me a thumbs up too if you like the recipe. And now we'll be putting in spinach. And again stirring, and now reduce the flame to medium. And let everything cook for about 5 to 7 minutes. This is basically a no tomato recipe as well as an open pan recipe. Plus, spinach is really good for your hair and skin. It was favorite of Popeye, the sailor man. So one should have spinach. I was bored of having spinach pakoras and dal palak, that is pearl spinach. And I was bored of having palak paneer, that is spinach paneer. So I thought of this because it's really good and different for our tongue buds. So now we'll cook for about 5 minutes. So very less ingredients are needed in this recipe, so it's really good. Do try. So now we'll leave it for about 5 minutes and then we'll see. Adding in 1/2 cup of water so that our chicken can get cooked properly. It shouldn't be raw. And now you can put your flame too high so that the chicken can get cooked and also the water gets evaporated and we can have a thick gravy. And later on, once it is done, we'll garnish it with chopped coriander. So this will take another 5 minutes. So friends, our palak gosht is ready and now we'll garnish it with coriander. Not too much, but little bit. So I hope you like the recipe. If you did, then do give me a thumbs up. It will make me very happy. Plus it motivates me and brings a smile on my face. Also leave a comment which is your favorite spinach recipe. And do not forget to subscribe my channel and be a part of Foodie Mom's community. I really love all of you. So I'll see you next time. Till then, take care. Bye.